The biodiversity crisis is devastating our ecosystems and affecting our health, our food security, and our economies. We need to improve now our relationship with nature and understand its value. Circular economy offers an alternative economic model where natural resources are kept at their highest value for as long as possible. GACERE, the Global Alliance on Circular Economy and Resource Efficiency, is committed to support global just circular economy transitions and more sustainable management of natural resources by demonstrating how a shift towards a circular economy can halt and reverse biodiversity loss. Ecosystems cannot keep up with our demands. Environmental decline concerns everyone, rich and poor, but it disproportionately affects the health of vulnerable and disadvantaged groups. The restorative and regenerative dimensions of the circular economy have been overlooked, and yet they can reduce pressures on ecosystems and inspire regenerative models for biodiversity. Circular economy helps restore biodiversity as it promotes a more efficient use of natural resources. For example, a circular model encourages food designers to create menus with diverse and local ingredients. It minimizes waste, reduces pressure on agricultural land, provides economic opportunities, and enhances resilience.
El Ministerio del Ambiente ha implementado programas de bionegocios que tienen un fondo de 20 millones de dólares para otorgar créditos a más de 6,000 pequeños y medianos negocios en la Amazonía, que reduzca la presión sobre los ecosistemas y garanticen la aplicación de prácticas sostenibles de regeneración de la naturaleza con el uso de fertilizantes naturales o la incorporación de pesticidas biológicos, eficiencia en el uso de materias primas e insumos incluidos el agua y la energía, utilización de los residuos para nuevos subproductos y también como materia orgánica para la conservación de los suelos. Finalmente, para el Perú, la economía circular incluye un enfoque de transición justa. Por ello es fundamental el desarrollo de una economía circular, ponga en valor los conocimientos ancestrales y garantice que los beneficios de las prácticas de nuestros pueblos sean repartidos equitativamente.
In a circular economy for textiles, products are used for longer, designed to be repaired and recycled, and made from safe and recycled or renewable inputs. Demand for virgin materials is reduced, waste and pollution are eliminated, while soil health is improved and water consumption is reduced.
Chile has first-hand experience of the negative impacts of improper textile waste management. Illegal landfills have proliferated, generating pollution of the landscape, soil, and air. And Chile has also a high per capita clothing consumption rate, which has increased from 13 to 15 garments per person between 2015 and 2020. To address these challenges, Chile is developing a national circular economy strategy for textile, focusing on prevention and reduction, involving all actors of the chain and citizens as well. The goal is to promote through public policy prevention, reuse, repair, and recycling with a systems approach to transform the textile industry and mitigate its impact on the environment and on biodiversity.
Circular economy can transform the way we design, produce, and use materials in the built environment, which reduces the demand for virgin materials. It helps create healthy cities where nature is integrated by design, improving water quality, resilience to climate shocks, but also mental health. Circularity can also inspire regenerative solutions for nature. Forests represent about 80% of the world's terrestrial biodiversity. They provide important ecosystem services, such as carbon sequestration, biodiversity conservation, and protection of water resources. Circular approaches such as continuous cover forestry can create timber production systems which improve soil health and water quality. Circular and regenerative agricultural approaches include using organic fertilizers, crop rotation, or agroecology. It maintains agricultural land's productivity instead of degrading them and reduces the need to expand them. Our failure to recognize the true costs of natural resources prevents a transition to sustainable and circular economies. Finance flows into nature are currently considerably smaller than the flow of climate finance. Circular economy can address the underlying drivers of biodiversity loss, land use change and habitat conversion, overexploitation, climate change and pollution. Circularity is an essential part of the transformations we need to achieve the targets of the Kunming-Montreal Global Biodiversity Framework. Visit unep.org/GACERE and learn more about the work of GACERE.